Hey everybody, welcome back to Live on Stage. I am your host, Lucio Fernandez. Muy buenas noches, señoras y señores. Bienvenidos a En Vivo y en Escena conmigo, Lucio Fernandez. Tenemos tremendo show esta noche porque tenemos la artista Liza Calache aquí en nuestro programa de televisión. También tenemos a Ariacne Trujillo en el piano. That's right, we have an incredible show for you guys. Tonight we have Liza Calache, a fine artist, a dancer, a chemistry teacher, doing her thing right here on live on stage. And we also have Ariacne Trujillo, Ariacne Trujillo, what a piano player. Stop it, we're going, check out the show. Enough of this, enough of that, let's do it, people. Check this out and come back to me, the Cuban kid. Peace out, people. We're here with Liza Calache. She's going to tell us about her wonderful art, her experiences, what moves her to do this crazy stuff, what moves her to break plates all over her house in order to create this beautiful art. I don't know. If my wife broke a plate, I just ran out. But she's breaking plates all over Union City, creating this beautiful art, and she's making a go of it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Live on Stage, Ms. Liza Calache. Welcome, Liza. Tell us a little bit about your art, what inspires you, where you come from, where were you born. How come you have such beautiful curly hair?
Well, I was actually born in Brussels, Belgium, but I'm also half Egyptian, so that explains the black hair. Otherwise, I'd have blonde hair. But I live in Union City, New Jersey, and I've lived here almost all my life. I went to school here and everything, but I did not study art. That's the first question everybody asked me. I studied chemistry, but I've always had an appreciation for art. And what inspired me to do my mosaics was when I first landed in an Orlando airport and I looked down at the floor and saw all these colors made out of tiles. So when I got home, the very first thing I could do was find a tile and do the same thing. So I had to break the tile and I didn't know how to do it. I had no tools, so I threw them on the floor and I shattered all the pieces that I possibly could. And when I saw them, I thought of how could I recreate something with these broken pieces. And I designed something and glued each piece together and I thought it was amazing. So my very first piece was a Yankee plate, about 9-inch round plate, and with the Yankees logo. And I gave it to my friend and he was so amazed by it. He said, "You can make a business out of this." I said, "I don't want to make a business. I just want to do art." But when he said that, it inspired me to create art that had more feeling in it. So now every time I create a piece, I have a riddle behind each one of them. And I hope that the title can also inspire the riddle and people can understand it.
Now, tell us about some of the themes. I see that you have a recurring theme of Michael Jackson in some of the pieces. Tell us about that theme in particular.
Well, I absolutely love music, and music inspires a lot of the artwork that you see here. Obviously, emotions and relationships that I've gone through, but music is the number one theme. For each piece, actually, I find a song that deals with the emotions that I'm feeling, and I just keep it on replay all day long until I can recite the lyrics. And when I'm recreating that piece, I can remember each emotion that I felt when I was listening to that song. Each piece that I broke, I can remember what it looked like before I put it on there. So it's pretty amazing. But I've always been inspired by Michael Jackson. He was a creative genius. His dancing, everything was just creative. And he's not the only one. Prince is also a great inspiration. So I have a lot of pieces dedicated to them.
You say about breaking tiles, breaking pieces. Is it an aggression thing? Explain that to me. Such a beautiful girl breaking tiles all over town.
Well, it's definitely a stress reliever, I can tell you that much. There's a lot of emotion that goes out when I break those tiles, but it's also, I can feel love also for each piece. That it deserves a special place. Actually, the best way I could describe my artwork is it's a puzzle, but I get to create what it looks like. I get to design each piece. If it doesn't fit, you make it fit.
Now, you have a piece called Fish Soup. Yes. Fish Soup. Tell us a little bit about that piece. I know the story, but I want the people watching the show to hear what this explanation is.
Okay. Well, Fish Soup, we are sitting in front of Fish Soup, and this piece actually represents me in its entirety, because if you know anything about me, I'm an artist, but an artist in every way. I don't just make mosaics. I act, I sing, I dance, I'm a choreographer, I model. So I'm pulled in a million different directions. And one time I counted, it was actually 8. So I said, wow, that's like an octopus. So I was like, okay, let me make a mosaic of an octopus. But I didn't want it to stop there. I wanted it to branch out into the different feelings that I have. So each fish represents a different feeling and a different emotion and a different side of me. Like, for, I don't know if you can see it down there, but there's a star. So I'm a star, I'm a diva. So that has to be on there. If you look at Nemo, the clownfish, I'm silly and I'm goofy. I'm forgetful like Dory. So every piece represents something about me.
Now, you mentioned that you you do various different things. One of the interesting things that I found about you is that you're a chemistry teacher. How did that come about?
Well, I actually went to school. I went to high school at Union City High School. It was back then Union Hill High School. And I was always interested in science because my father was a doctor. And we kind of didn't have a choice about what we wanted to be. We were going to be doctors, all of us. So I went to college and studying chemistry with the hopes of going to medical school. But I realized that my passion didn't really lie in being with sick people all day. But it was kind of a little too late for me to change anything because I was already a senior in college when I found that out. So I said, what else am I going to do with a chemistry degree? So I went to go visit my old high school teacher, and she's like, what are you doing with yourself? I'm like, I don't have a job. She said, well, why don't you become a teacher? And I didn't really want to go back to school for that. She's like, no, there's an alternate route program. You could start teaching and go back to school at night. I was like, okay. So I became a teacher, and I'm there ever since, 10 years. And I absolutely love being around the kids. It's like my little audience. They listen to everything I say, and I get to practice my lines on them.
Now, also, okay, so you do art, you discover art, and you're self-taught, and how's that changed your life, doing the plastic arts as a working with mosaics?
Well, I pretty much have no other life. It's pretty bad. My friends all are like, they always want me to go out with them, and I have absolutely no time. My bedroom has now turned into one huge closet, because I don't even do my laundry anymore. But I honestly love my life. I'm one of the few people that can say I do everything. I'm not just the 9-to-5 person and with the boring life, okay, what am I going to do now? I'm trying to find out, when can I sit and when can I eat and when can I sleep? But that, for me, that works for me. I love my life.
Now, you also, aside from, okay, you're a chemistry teacher, you do the mosaic art, this is a wonderful exhibit, people really loved it tonight, but also you're a Zumba instructor. And you're doing a wonderful, wonderful program with the kids at the high school with the dance arts. Tell us a little bit about that program and about you being a teacher of Zumba and also teaching the ballroom.
I've been a ballroom dancer for 12 years. And it's funny, when I started teaching in the high school, one of the students passed by the studio that I was practicing and they're like, is that Miss Calache? I said, yeah, that's me. The next day they come up to me like, Miss, is it true? And I'm trying to figure out what is it that they found out about me. They're like, we heard, is it true? And they're like, we found out you're a dancer. I'm like, yes, that's true. Like, can you please teach us? There were two students. They're like, can you please teach us? I'm like, sure, absolutely. They're like, we want to go to prom, but we want to be able to know how to dance. So I was like, okay, I'll teach you. They wanted to learn the tango. I taught them within 2 months. The news started spreading that I'm a teacher and that I'm a dancer. And by the end of the year, I had about 20 students. They're like, Miss, why don't we make this a club? They call me Miss. Miss, why don't we make this a club? So after school, my first year teaching, we had dance club at Union Hill High School. The next year, word started spreading. Over the years, I had to have now auditions to have these kids in here because so many people were interested. But within the last 3 years, when we were at the Union City High School, they have a dance room where we can actually practice. We didn't have that Union Hill. I was practicing in hallways, in stairways, in classrooms where we had to move the desks around. But now that we actually had a place to be dancers, we took it to the next level. We now had a serious name for ourselves. We're now the Latin Fire Dancers. com. Check us out. But we perform all over the place now. Now we have people asking us, paying us to dance for them at their events. And we just recently had a wonderful show that we put on called We're on Fire, where we had dances from all over the world, a 2-hour show. And it's absolutely incredible. You can see the pictures online and videos coming soon. So I'm absolutely proud about that.
Now, what's the website again?
LatinFireDancers.com.
I remember when I first met you years ago, we were actually at a function at Union Hill High School, and I knew you were a chemistry teacher. I knew who your father was, obviously. And when I first found out you were also a dancer, and then I was like, what? A chemistry teacher is a dancer? And then I found out you're doing art, and I was like, this is phenomenal, because you were also doing an art show in New York. What's the last, 2 years ago?
In Brooklyn.
How did that go?
That was absolutely phenomenal. I sold about 4 pieces there, so it was an art gallery in Brooklyn. It was very nice.
What's next? What's coming up for you?
I'd like to take it to the next level, the next solo exhibit. You tell me. Help me out here. But I love to perform, and I love to do my artwork, and I love to combine both, so I'm ready.
I think one of the shows is going to be Lisa's art show with a performance, and then she's going to be doing monologues. She's going to be doing Zumba. She's going to be dancing ballroom, and she's going to
and a photo shoot.
Now, also, Lisa, I know a friend of mine who runs HudsonCountyTV.com is also going to be using her. I actually produced that show with him. She's going to be doing that show as a correspondent. So that's kind of cool. So she can do even that. I can't believe it. Anything else you want to add?
I just love this opportunity, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart for letting me do this. So thank you very much.
No, thank you. So anyway, let's go check out Lisa's art and then come back to me in the studio. Peace out, people. That was Liza Calache's art. Whoa, that girl can do her thing, man, mosaics and stuff. Anyway, let's go to a different kind of artist. Is a musician. Vamos a chequear ahora en vez de arte. Vamos a la música. Let's check out Ariacne Trujillo. She's going to talk to us, and then she's going to play the piano and sing. Check this out. Come back to me later, people. Peace out, baby. We're here with Ariacne Trujillo. A wonderful musician, pianist, singer, and a wonderful, wonderful performer. We're happy to have her here on Live on Stage. Ariacne, tell us a little bit about yourself. First of all, where do you come from? Where were you born? And tell us a little bit about your background that way.
Okay, hi, how you doing? Well, I was born in Havana. I'm not going to say what year, I'm just kidding. I was born in Havana, and I was raised there, and I studied there. In Central Havana, actually, and I studied middle levels for, I don't know, 16 years of my life. I studied over there classical music. I'm a classical trained musician, and when I came in 2002 to the United States of America.
Now tell us a little bit about, yes, you were born in Havana, Cuba, but what brought you to music? Was it a love for music? Did you stumble into a piano? Did a piano fall on your head, or a guitar? Are your family musicians? How do you come about to become a musician?
Well, I think that I fall on the piano. I'm just kidding. Well, my mom, she's a flutist for I don't know how many years from the symphonic orchestra and the orchestra of the ballet and of Alicia Alonso and the opera. My grandfather, he wasn't a professional, but he used to play tres, guitar. And my uncle, he was a professional flutist, so they're all flutists. And so when I was like 4 years old, my mom, she just brought a piano to my house. She had no idea I was gonna try to play the piano, but I'd sit down, and my grandma, she used to sing a little bit of lullabies and Mexican songs and stuff like that. So I just went into the piano by ear. I just started playing at 4 years old. So they were like, okay, that's a game. She could do it. But then at six, I just got to the school, and I was into a classical world, and they were freaking out totally. They were like, oh my God, no. So I did everything, and I've been singing. I act in a lot of TV shows since I was little, a lot of competitions, a lot of dance competitions too, because I love to dance, compositions. I mean, I started doing a lot of stuff, and school, of course, classical piano. So
at 4 years old, you're basically a prodigy, a child prodigy, and that drove you to play the piano in school. They were blown away by you. Now, how long have you been in the United States?
Since 2002, actually 10 years I've been here. And this has been crazy because I have been doing so many things. I used to, before I came here, I used to be a singer and a dancer in Tropicana of Cuba, the cabaret. Actually, it was incredible experience that I always wanted to do, because I was a classical girl, but I always felt, you know, blind by the suits and all the craziness of the cabaret. So I did it, and when I came here, I decided to start doing ballroom dancing. So I did ballroom. I lost like I don't know how many pounds, and I did a lot of competitions, and I started playing in New York, but I'm playing classical music and playing music normal, right? Like timba, soul. I start studying like soul music, blues, R&B. I start getting crazy with that, and so that's what I'm right now. I'm a little bit of everything. That's my style now. But I've been doing backup singer, and I mean, I've been a backup singer with Paul Simon. I've been a singer I've been playing and singing with Johnny Pacheco, Paquito de Rivera. Actually, I went to the Apollo Theater like 2 weeks ago, and I played with, I shared a stage with Taj Mahal. So many people, it's like incredible what I have been going and what I have been doing in this country, actually.
For those of you who don't know, Tropicana is the world famous Tropicana is the hottest cabaret, not only in Cuba, Havana, Cuba, but probably in the whole world. And it's what probably gave birth to all the casinos and the cabaret shows in Atlantic City, in Vegas, even Paris. A lot of the singers, Nat King Cole, Frank Sinatra, they all performed at Tropicana. And for any artist to perform in Tropicana is a big deal. And since she came to the United States performing with got Paul Simon. I would love to go and perform with Paul Simon and at the Apollo Theater. Now, what's next for you? Are you recording a CD? Have you recorded a CD?
Well, actually, I have a 14-piece band of a timba band that was called La Bola that we record already. But actually, I have a duo with my mom that she just came from Cuba, and we're trying to promote that. Classical music, world music, and a little bit of Cuban music. And I'm playing with a group, a quartet, which is not my group, but I'm a lead singer and pianist, and we're traveling a lot. And we're working 3 days in New York. I'm doing a lot of traveling with this, with Pedrito Martinez group. That's the one I'm playing, actually. I'm working a lot with, as a lead singer with one of the girls' bands in New York. It's called Coco Mama. Those are my girls. And I'm doing a lot of Cuban music with them, and they're doing their own music. And I have my quintet too, and I have a trio too, so I'm very busy doing a lot of stuff, actually.
Well, she's playing with everybody. She's like, this is like a one-woman band playing with all the hottest groups. Pedrito Martinez, a great percussion, Latin percussionist, really well-known. He's pretty much recorded with everybody. So, the Coco Mama, who else is in that?
My mom is Mayra Casales. She's from Cuban, Miami, and they're not Cuban. They're different, from different countries, and they're incredible musicians. We are set in New York City. Actually, and yeah, I have my acquainted, and we're gonna record two more videos now. I have two more videos on YouTube, Ariacne Trujillo acquainted, if you want to see it. And I'm working too with my trio, and I'm doing everything. I'm getting busy. I have a lot of things to do.
Well, now I also know Mayra Casales, and Mayra Casales is a great percussionist, incredible percussion, lots of energy, very animated when she plays. So she's playing with top people everywhere. You're like all over the place. And I know you're playing with all these different groups, and you're playing with your mom now, but how about you? How about Ariacne Trujillo? When is Ariacne Trujillo going to do a CD of her own featuring Ariacne Trujillo?
Well, that's coming. I don't know. I'm setting up everything, and you know, I never say no to the things that come to me, and I've been teaching too, I've been doing a lot of stops, but definitely, yeah, probably next year you're gonna have a CD, you're gonna be the first one.
All right, thank you for being here with us. Anyway, let's go here, Ariacne, play a little bit of music. We'll come back to me in the studio. Check this out, everybody.
Como si fuera esta noche.
Can she play the piano? Man, can she sing Bésame Mucho? I wish I could sing and play like that, but I wasn't born with that gift. But boy, did I look good. I look sharp with the white shirt and the red tie and the pinstripes. I look hot, baby. That's what I'm talking about. You, let me talk. I was hot. I was hot in that interview. Anyway, people, look me up, thecubankid.com, luciofernandez.com. Read about me. See what I'm doing. Yes, it's over. This is the end of the show. Till next time, this is your host, Lucio Fernandez. Good night, everybody. Hasta la vista, baby. Call me up. Call me.